name is Tony Hall. I'm the mayor for the city of Gaston. I've lived here the majority of my life. You can see how beautiful it is here in Gaston. We're surrounded by farmland, nurseries, and if you look in the background, you'll see mountains. I have been to the One Horse Tavern. It's a nice establishment here in Gaston. Wendy is the owner, and when she came in here a number of years ago, she remodeled the One Horse and made it into a very nice place to go and get something to eat.
My name is Wendy Chamberlain, and I am the owner of the One Horse Tavern. The mosaics I did, kind of a hobby of mine, and I just hours of getting up and down on ladders and gluing glass. I think it makes the tavern so much more special inside. It kind of has a little cathedral style feel to it that I love. I think the area is beautiful. Just the drive out, it's a really beautiful country. The wineries really make it. You go up, there's some beautiful ones. Plum Hill, Montanor, Kramer are closest to us. That we get a lot of customers that come from there, and the beautiful places to go sit, enjoy some wine, and look at the views. The Plum Hill people are great. Very friendly, very low-key winery. No wine snobs allowed.
I'm R.J. Lynn from Plum Hill Vineyards. We're a small winery, so we can do a lot of different things that large wineries can't. We have Pinot Noir, which everybody has in Oregon. We have the Pinot Gris, which is the other. We've planted Syrah. We have Pinot Blanc. And we have a grape called Schoenberger, when we're the only commercial vineyard of it in the USA. We have converted the old farmhouse into a tasting room. I built the bar inside myself. We're very, very dog friendly. A lot of our clientele bring their dogs on the weekend, sit on the patio and have a drink. My wife is a real crafter, if you will, and so we have a lot of local artisan stuff in the gift shop, you know, and it's a fairly extensive gift shop. We have a covered patio, so you know it's open all year round. Right now there's probably three wineries here, and we're less than 2 miles apart, so you can hit wineries, you know, quite easily. And it's just got that really neat little small town atmosphere.
We have a number of activities we can do here, from hiking in the Trask Mountain Range or hunting in the Trask Mountain Range to Hag Lake directly behind me, just over that hill.
Beautiful. It's a great drive. The lake is lovely, and there's a lot of stops around the way, and you can bike a lot of bikers around it. We get a lot of bikers who go around Hag Lake and then come down and have lunch, and it's a fun place to hang out. A lot of fishermen and boaters up there too.
At one time we were going to call our place Plum Hill Vineyards and Bait Shop, because we used to get all the fishermen on their way there or on their way back to show us their catch.
Bald Peak is a beautiful place to go for viewing.
I think the uniqueness of the Gaston area and the Gaston vineyards and wineries is the chances of you meeting the winemaker or the assistant winemaker or the owners is very high.
I feel like I've made a lot of really great friends here. I've gotten to know a lot of wonderful people through my customers that live in Gaston, and have found it to be a really lovely and fun little town.